Walking among us are seemingly ordinary people with regular daily lives, studying, working, and existing just like anyone else. But on the dance floor, these people come to life. With some people even going international with their abilities.
Sydney, as well as other major Australian cities, is home to a very active dance community with showcases, jams, and battles constantly happening. But what exactly is a dance battle like? Should we expect to see the stuff Hollywood shows us? Today, we'll be stepping into a Sydney dance battle to see exactly what goes down.
And as you can see behind me, we've got a line of super excited and super talented dancers who will be showcasing exactly what they're made of today and trying to determine who's the best at battling. But without further ado, it's time to go inside. Wait a minute, what's going on? Why is everyone dancing? What is this place? Just keep dancing. Why? Why don't they stop? What's going on? Who are you? Who's this? In the suburb of Marrickville, you'll find one of the most well-known dancers in the Sydney dance community. Having danced for over two decades and seen their fair share of events, this person is no stranger to a battle.
Hey, what's up? It's Poppin' Jack. No, I don't like that. Hey, what's up? It's Jack Wardana, aka Poppin' Jack. I'm 33 years old. I started dancing since I was in primary school, and I teach the dance style of popping.
Poppin' Jack has been invited to judge a battle called Party Mode, a 5v5 all-style dance battle, where any style goes, as opposed to a style-specific battle. On theme with the teams of five, he'll be joined by four other judges to determine who is the best. Who is the best? Who is
the best? My experience learning dance when I was younger in primary school was great because I got out of my comfort zone and I met new people. Some people were like higher skill level at the time than me, and I wanted to strive to get better and stuff like that. And really pushed me to get better, like when I was younger.
Jack could be found sharing his knowledge every Sunday at Marrickville. Being one of the most experienced poppers in Sydney, his class serves as a great entry point for those who want to try the style.
Teaching dance full time to me is just something I always wanted to do because I love it, you know? So I always wanted to do something that I love. And so the opportunity to teach classes and make a living off of dance, but also do something that I love was great for me. So I really wanted to do my best to pursue something that I felt passionate about.
You can find posts of himself or his students getting down on Instagram under the rather counterintuitive name Newtown Popping. Even though the classes are based in Marrickville, I think it's a tradition thing.
So I'm here at the battle today at Woolloomooloo PCYC for Party Mode, which is run by one of the uni dance societies, MODSOC. And we're here for a 5-on-5 street dance competition. And I'm going to be one of the judges. As a judge, because this is a team battle, 5v5, I'm looking for a lot of teamwork, great connection with the music. If possible, some routines would be great because it is a team battle. And just that connection between the music, the floor, and the audience, and just making a real show of it. So the main difference I feel between a one-on-one dance battle and a team battle is the fact that you have more people to work with. It can't just be like a bunch of individuals dancing. It needs to become a group, so that group needs to mold together.
So we're here today with one of the participants, and why don't you just introduce yourself to everyone?
Hey, so my name is Jason, I'm 25, been dancing for 10 years, and my dance style is popping.
So what got you into dance in the first place?
So back in like when I was still in high school, like I saw like a bunch of friends just like dancing, and I got kind of like peer pressure into dancing, and then that's how I started with like just a bunch of high school friends, and eventually I took it professionally.
At this event, dancers have formed teams of five, with five judges determining who will make it through. Preliminary rounds are conducted in a typical team versus team format, with each dancer required to go out once for 30 seconds. However, each team is marked based on the standards and preferences of the five judges, so it is possible for two teams that verse each other to both make it through, or for none of them to make it through, depending on their score.
Right now, I am joined today by yet another competitor. Why don't you introduce yourself to everyone out there?
Hi, I'm Candy Divine. I am 28 years old this year, and I'm a whacker, and I've been whacking for 4 years.
What brought you here today to Party Mode?
The battle.
Do you want to win?
Of course, who doesn't want to win?
That's right, excellent, I love to hear it. Can you tell us one thing you like about the Sydney dance community?
I like the connectedness, I like the inclusivity of the Sydney dance team, yeah.
From the initial pool of hopeful teams, the top eight are decided. Teams are then put against each other again, with the same conditions as the preliminary round. All dancers have to go out once for 30 seconds each.
From this point, the battles essentially become sudden death. Whoever has the most votes in a given battle will make it to the next round.
Why don't you introduce yourself to the people out there?
Hi, I'm Jasha. I am 22 years old. I've been dancing for around 3 or 4 years now, and I do a dance style called whacking.
Awesome. So how did you, what got you started in dancing?
Actually, I started dancing because I was watching like Beyonce videos in my room.
Beautiful.
And I was like copying the choreography and like trying to learn it. And then when I got into like university, I was like, oh, let me start like actually like pursuing dancing and like training and like see where that goes.
Awesome, awesome. I think we all aspire to be Beyonce in some way.
This will continue all the way to the finals, with the top four extending the time for each dancer to 45 seconds per round, and the finals allowing 2 45-second rounds from each dancer. At the finals, instead of an on-the-spot decision, judges will go off to discuss who they believe to be the winner before announcing the winners.
You're already basically in the mode.
Right, so.
Yeah, oh. In the mode, Party Mode. We're outside here at Party Mode, and we've got another battler, actually all the way down from Melbourne. Oh, why don't you introduce yourself to the camera?
Oh, so my name is Chun. Some people call me Cambodia, which is my stage name, I guess. So I am 30 years of age, and yeah, I'm currently living in Melbourne, Victoria, and glad to be here at Party Mode.
So, you know, you've been from Melbourne. What can you tell us a little bit about the Melbourne dance scene? What's something you like about it?
I saw like the Melbourne dancing is actually really wholesome. Like, we're all almost like as a family there. I think because of the number of people that are dancing in Melbourne as well, it's not as many as in Sydney. So like you would know like the other person that's dancing in that other battle, for example. And so everyone's really tight knit in that sense.
And for those out there who may have never danced before or never seen it, never tried it, what's a tip you can give for an absolute beginner trying to get into dance?
Just do it. Just literally, you close your eyes.
You heard it here first, guys. Close your eyes. Seven News, we know the news. Thank you so much for your time, Chun.
It's clear to see that even with such diverse backgrounds, interests, and reasons to dance, all these people come together to exchange, showcase, and share in the art of dance. While some battles can have more personal beef behind it, most of the time, it's all love and respect.
Everyone and everybody, if you're ready for the final, let me hear you say, hell yeah!
And we've just come to the conclusion of Party Mode. That was a wild finals, wouldn't you agree? What were you looking for in those finals?
Just people taking it to the next level, you know, like giving it their all and making sure they leave everything out on the floor. We had people who were injured still dancing on the chair, as you saw. And yeah, just people who were really just willing to risk it all and just go for it.
What yourself would you like to see more of in like the Sydney dance community itself?
Well, you know, we're still recovering after COVID. So I think just more people getting into dance and still realizing we still have events going on. And we're obviously rebuilding like a lot of other industries and arts. So just for people to come back to dance and know that we're still here, we're still running events and, you know, we need all the help we can get, I guess.
Well, there you have it, guys. Popping Jack. Thank you so much for allowing us to basically follow you the whole day and all your insights that you've had. And yeah, thank you for judging the event as well. This must have been a very tough event to judge given the skill level that we've seen. And that's the end of it all. We're done here. We're done.
And there you have it. A dance battle as it is here in Sydney. Now, truth be told, this stuff is quite familiar to me, but for those out there who have never seen it before, I hope you found this video interesting. And for those aspiring dancers out there who are kind of on the fence about battling or learning dance, I just have one thing to say to you guys. Do it.
Everyone seems to just be dancing here. They're just non-stop dancing. Dancing in front of the toilet. Dancing everywhere. Very strange obsession. I've never seen this before in my life.